Ready, Joe? Hit it.
Chin on the ground, there's a lot to be learned. So look around, but he's got
How are you doing this evening? Oh, that wasn't good enough. How are you doing this evening? That's a little better. One more time. How are you doing this evening? That's more like it. We are the Rainbow Theater Project.
Enjoy. I practice a lot.
Amen. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong.
So it's garden party season, which of course made me think of Joe. And about a minute later, I picked up the phone to call Joe because there are so many things that he does for the garden party for us. And then I realized that I couldn't call Joe, and my heart felt really sad. But the memories are amazing.
I feel very lucky to have worked with Joe Rojek. He was a great coworker, and every time there was a problem or something to solve, he was always so fun and creative to work with, and he would always help us come up with a great solution. And I also know that he was a really true friend to a lot of people who worked here and who received services here, and that's a pretty cool thing about Joe.
When I think of Joe, I think of the time that he taught several of us to dance and sing, and I would have to admit that I was not his prized pupil, but I did pretty good, so he was able to make that happen. But more importantly, what I remember about Joe and think of often is how much he did behind the scenes to make the organization go so smoothly, to make people look good, and to help families and clients, and he is missed every single day here.
I've known Joe Rojek for about a quarter of a century, and Joe Rojek, to me, was the perfect Renaissance man. Musician, talented professional here at the Moore Center. Teacher. But the qualities I will never forget are his gentleness and his modesty. You would never know how talented Joe Rojek was unless you learned it from others. And his sweetness, I'm reminded of the memorial service where I think it was his niece who spoke about how Joe taught her how to shuffle off to Buffalo. Joe Rojek is someone I will never forget, and I'm trying to be more like. I want to be more like Joe Rojek.
Hi, my name's Linda, and I've worked with Joe for over 30 years. This is a little hard, but I just have to say that he became a part of my life, and working here at the center is wonderful, but I've got a great big hole in my heart because I miss Joe so terribly.
I'm doing this video today out of respect for Joe. Joe passed away 6 months ago now, and I get through each day by trying to pretend it didn't happen. And Joe would be so upset with me for that. Joe is a man of great faith, and he's at peace, and I know that. And so I want to talk about him. I want to share some memories. I knew Joe for about 35 years. We were brought together sort of because of our compassion and love for the people that we serve. Their families, our own families. We were connected because of music and theater, and also because of our faith. And so I think it's really important to talk about him and to keep him ever present. When I'm in this building, the Moore Center, I can feel him everywhere. When I leave here and I do other things, I can feel him everywhere too. He's keeping in touch with me. I thought it was really important to share an example or a memory with you of something that happened a lot of years ago. Joe and I worked together in what we called dayhab 35 years ago. And we were working with this young woman who was very profoundly disabled. She was a tiny woman, maybe 5 feet tall, if that, and less than 90 pounds. She used to headbang, and one day she did this so severely that she cut open the side of her eye. And so we got help, we got her to the emergency room as fast as possible. It took 4 very strong, very healthy staff from the emergency room, plus Joe, to hold her down just to give her a shot. And then it took about 2 hours for that shot to take effect. We had to walk around the grounds of the Elliott Hospital for hours while it started to take effect on this young woman. And finally, all of a sudden, she just grabbed Joe and she literally crawled up into his arms and let him carry her into the emergency room to take care of the stitches that she needed in her eye. And I bring that memory up because it reminds me sort of who Joe was. He was somebody that the individuals we served cared for and trusted, no matter how difficult their lives were, and who made them feel safe. And that's who Joe was to me. He made me feel safe, I trusted him, he was there for the good times in my life, and he helped take care of me through the bad times. And I don't want to forget him. I don't want us to stop talking about him and to think about all the great memories. So, thank you, Joe. I miss you.
Joe was a long-term coworker of mine. We used to be part of what we used to jokingly call the 6 o'clock club. We called it that because after 6 p.m., a lot of people had left for the day. There was just a few of us that would be here, and we would get more work done sometimes because it was less interruptions. But we also spent time just chatting with each other, and that's where I learned more about Joe's personal life, and he learned more about mine. He was a really personable man, and he was always there for you. He was such a gentleman. We used to go out for lunch on Thursdays, there was a group of us that used to go out on Thursdays, and we would go out for lunch, and he was always the gentleman. He would go and get his car, and we would just go down in the elevator and wait for him to come up with the car for us, and he was just always going the extra mile for people, and I surely do miss him.
Joe was a great coworker and friend. I have a lot of great memories of him stopping by. He was my cubicle neighbor, and he'd stop by my office and always said he'd have a silly question for me. We'd end up chatting about his history and knowledge of the Moore Center, and sometimes just about life. He was a great guy, and he would be dearly missed, and most certainly not forgotten.
I really miss Joe, and he is such a sweet guy. If it was not for you, we would not be here with the dances and singing and having all different bodies to go to, everything that you've done for us, and we really appreciate it, and we missed you, and hope you're safe and sound up in heaven. We love you, we missed you. God bless you, Joe. Love you.